give this song to all the lovers tonight. And I expect that might be the whole world, because everybody needs something, someone to love.
Peace, love, and blessings. Got my mimosa. Sitting back, listening to Bessie Mikely. Beautiful sister. So, let's get it. Let's listen to her.
Round one. Fight!
Well, you know, since you're with it. Yeah, you know, it's interesting. So the past several months where I've been leading conversation.
Yes.
Amongst Black women and beyond. I think the main thing I've learned from this, y'all, is people really want Black women to be happy with anything. What people really want Black women to understand is that we are to be accepting of our positioning as the least desirable in society. We should get the memo that nobody really wants a Black woman. Thus, if anybody was to find themselves willing to take up with us, we should be happy, we should be grateful, and we should shut up about it. And if you are a Black woman that dares to push back on that mythology, because that's what it is, it's a damn lie from the pits of hell.
Right.
And you, if you were to push back on that and insist upon a value system, insist upon a criteria, insist upon just a standard into which we want to operate romantically, we are demonized.
Yes.
We are, you know, we are seen as ungrateful, and eventually we become the ungrateful, angry Black woman. And I'm not, I just...
And here we go.
Messy Mikey. Phenomenal piece. If you haven't already, please subscribe to her channel. Queen doing amazing things. She's beautiful. She's intelligent. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel as well. Comment, share, and like. Without further ado, hold on. Gotta take a sip, because this shit right here, I should have put a couple of shots of Casamigos in there. But here's the thing.
What the fuck? No! No, you dumb bitch! You were supposed
to... I don't know what that is. But those three, what comes out of their mouth is what they display. What she said. Let's make that perfectly clear. Now, I'm gonna let the queen spit. Listen, use your ear gate. Let's get it.
My nigga.
Y'all sit up on these damn panels that you complain about and do shit like what they're doing right now, and all you do is whine, complain, and blame, and shame. It's not right. It's racist. Every dog disproportionately affected. It's white supremacy. It's racism. It's crust, dust, rust, must, ashy bombs. It's everybody but you. Why is it that all y'all do is complain? It is not this hard. Honestly, it really is not this hard to find a man. But y'all want to lead with money. That's your problem. Your whole attitude, Ebony, as you speak, is a turnoff. But they don't want to hear stuff like that. That's just not even to talk bad about you. That's just to let you know you are, again, jumping over here, and then you're going to jump over there, and then you're going to jump over here, and then you're going to jump over there. Girl, you can't stand on shit. Ebony, you couldn't even get the white man to marry you, so what are we talking about right now?
You dumb asshole. No one is...
Y'all make this hard upon, put upon life on yourselves. Life is just not this hard. Y'all do it to yourselves. Don't blame nobody else. It doesn't matter in my head. This how this work, Ebony, Light Bright, Video Vixen, and Girl on the End. This how this work. Somebody says something I don't like, guess what? I don't give a shit.
Finish her.
Y'all just think that everything gotta be your damn way and you should have everything. Your attitude and you think your value is much higher than what it is. That's what the problem is. No one said that you gotta settle. Y'all complain about settling while you're showing you settle all damn time. Y'all support the shit that shows the most debaucherous, stupid ass shit about us, and y'all support it, i.e. every woman on Kendra G. Shout out to Kendra G, make your money. All I'm saying is that all those crazy ass people coming up there, don't talk about her. You can't talk about Black women. So in other words, there's no bottom. There's no top. It's anything goes. Fine. Let everything be what it's going to be.
So fuck you. Fuck you.
and fuck you, and fuck this.
Every woman is saying the exact same thing. Why is it that every woman is saying the same damn thing? As a man, we get tired of hearing that same damn song playing in our fucking tape deck.
You fucked up big time.
Take a page out of Simone Biles' book. She saw what she liked. She went after it. They went on a simple date to go get milk and cookies. He is the prize. She's the prize. When two good people come together, motherfucker, they both the prize.
Oh, no, you dumb bitch.
He didn't lean in with his accolades. She never leaned in with her accolades. But they both leaned in with the intent to build a future. And look at them now. So what? You never heard of Jonathan Owens. We ain't never heard of Light Bright. Ain't never heard of this, whatever this is right here. Same damn thing. But who cares? Simone Biles has a man. She has somebody to come home to. She has someone to build an empire and a life with. What the fuck y'all have? Not a damn thing. Let's get it.
Number two. Fight.
Let everything be whatever the hell it's going to be, and then never wonder why you got people over here talking about you looking half damn crazy. And I say y'all, because y'all the ones looking for men, then we'll turn around talking about I'm a boss, I don't need a man. Y'all don't even know what you want. You do this shit to yourselves.
Fatality.
I don't want to blame everybody else. Why do I care about what some man says about what he want a damn woman? Yo, man, I'm gonna be there. I like this for me. I like that for me. I like this for me. I like that for me. Y'all are so here, there, and everywhere. You stand on nothing. You go with whatever your emotion is at the time. You mad at any and every man because they not bound down kissing your damn feet. That's what the problem is. You mad that they not down there kissing your ass and your feet. That's what it is. Because I'm a black woman. And that means that everybody's supposed to bow down to you. That's not how life works.
So fuck you. Fuck you. And fuck you. And
just not.
Boo fucking who? Men ain't got to do shit. The fact that men have options and go in there and decided to go their own way. Y'all got a problem with that. Y'all dehydrated, modern, feminist pirates got a problem with that. With a man going his own way. Shout out to Passport Bros. When a man is getting sick and tired, not even getting sick and tired, when a man has made up in his mind he's done, he's fucking done. You're done. You're a tax write-off. Ain't no man gonna settle for some loud mouth. Don't wanna listen. Ignorant, procrastinating, thinking you the finest thing since sliced bread, arrogant, broken, selfish, meanie woman. Ain't no man gonna settle for that. But I guarantee you, it's heifers like y'all on Valentine's Day, that's going to be lonely, that's going to use your rose, and that's going to use your fingers.
Your personal life too. Stop allowing people into your personal life that don't meet up to your minimum expectation. Like I said, women should be FBI, feminine, beautiful, and inspirational.
Because ain't no good man going to spend money and put up with y'all. Facts.
How it works. That's just not how it works. But y'all don't want to listen to that. And then to have these people, not a married person on this damn panel, not near one, not who in a relationship here? Does anybody know? We know Ebony's not. We know Light Bright is doing everything. Girl, that's her talk. That's her talk. She down for threesomes, doing this, doing that, anytime, any place, a woman, a man, probably a dog, allegedly, child, I don't know. But she was talking real greasy on that damn show about all the sexual things that she do. So I'm not saying that Ebony does that, and I don't know who the woman on the left does, but hell, we got Melissa Ford on this damn panel. Melissa damn Ford.
When it's cold outside, who are you holding?
Movies where the bus driver looks like Boris Kodjo. And in that case, bring him on.
The thing about the bus driver, y'all motherfuckers done just missed it. The point of that, and the point that Tyler Perry made when he made a statement about a man paying as much as a light bill, it's about both parties contributing, having something to bring to the table.
Hey, moron!
A large number of you dehydrated, modern feminist pirates don't bring shit to the damn table, but have all these expectations of what a man should bring to the table. But soon as a man talk about what a woman should bring to the table, you got a problem with that. You and your emotions, you and your feelings. You know what? Fuck you. Stay by your damn self. Continue to deal with the Pookie and Ray Rays that you're familiar with, that you're accustomed to. And leave good men alone. Leave good, hard-working, loving men alone that want something out of life. You know what? I do you one better. Don't leave us alone. We're checking out by ourselves. We will gladly, humbly remove ourselves from your damn presence. We gonna go elsewhere. And if that consists of going overseas, so be it. It's gonna be what it's gonna be. And all y'all cackling hens can sit there huddled up together and have a motherfucking pity party. Talking about man ain't shit. No, you ain't shit.
Gentlemen, if no one's told you, you gotta tell yourself, you are special. You are important. You are the man.
Who you chose versus who you pass up. Boy, me and Messy Michael, we on fire today. We're going to burn this.
Round three. Fight.
So the bus driver's okay as long as he looks like Boris Kodjo. She said that as an insult. Tyler Perry makes movies where you make the bus driver look like Boris Kodjo. So in other words, she's doubling down on Ebony's bus drivers ain't ish. That's fine, Melissa Ford, okay? That shows and proves exactly what I am saying. You will go ahead and go for the lowest of the low and then get mad at Tyler Perry for saying the exact same thing that y'all say. Put it in reverse. I want a man to come in here and take care of me and all eight of my kids and my two baby daddies. I live in a truck and he need to pay all the bills. Yay! I need a man to come in here and take care of everything and make over $250,000 and take care of me and all my kids while I do what I do and keep all my money and he can take care of all of us, and if not, he ain't a man.
You disloyal fool ass bitch made punk.
Shut y'all asses up. Acting like y'all fucking Mr. Get Bad. Don't have a pot to piss in and a window to throw it out of. What relationship that you know of that they were in where they were loved, treated, and getting their back blown out? Don't worry. I'll wait. I'll sit my Hermosa and wait.
Flawless victory.
If you're clearly telling us, just like when we watch Kendra G's videos, y'all, that you keep finding the same person. Because if you could get what the F it is that you wanted, then you would have it.
I feel like black men don't really want to have the conversation that black women actually do have more options that are available to them than are ever.
That's bullshit. That's bullshit. More men have more options than women. Let's make that perfectly clear. They're actually showing you, when the men have their passports and they're going overseas, they're showing you that they have more options. Men are not choosing. I don't know who the fuck that is. It. Men are not choosing dehydrated, modern, feminist pirates. They're not choosing them. I don't care how good you look. That don't mean shit. Can you keep a man? Do you know how to love? Are you ready to love?
What am I going to do with you, Steve Urkel? Just love me, Laura. Love me like I love you. Come here.
The best version of yourself is seen by many, then you will be able to say, you know what, let me sit back and let me listen to a man talk. Let me listen to a man's needs. Let me understand him. Let me fall back and understand him, where he's coming from, what his needs are. What he needs me to be. Let me stop being so damn complicated and difficult to deal with. Let me shut my mouth. That shit's hard, huh?
Excellent. Fatality.
But if you do that, that thing right there, and understand the definition of teamwork, 50-50, teamwork, and be that man's peace and love and respect that man, then you may have someone. Until then.